Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, The Planted Cauliflower. Today we are going to talk about five big leaf Hoyas in my personal collection, how I care for them, and what I think of them. Please leave me a comment, let me know what big leaf Hoyas you have in your collection, and let's go ahead and get started.
I want to be daring, baby, dance the night away. I let my head down if I want. Don't you just get tired chasing fame and being pretty all the time?
Okay guys, let's go ahead and get going. The first big leaf Hoya I have in my collection is Hoya Latifolia. Known as the big dinner plate Hoya, this plant produces leaves almost as big, if not bigger, than a dinner plate. It is absolutely great. Mine is smaller, obviously. It's still just a baby, but it does have two leaves, and a nice tendril coming out of it. As you can see, it's very happy. It's currently in soil. I do intend to change that at some point and put it into either leca or pond, but right now it's happy in soil, so I'm happy just leaving it alone until I find it a priority. She lives in my Millsbow cabinet and gets lots of nice light from my grow lights and humidity from the environment that it's in, and it stays nice and warm, and it's doing really well. I did get it with the one big leaf and the tendril has since elongated as well as produced a leaf for me. One leaf that's also slightly deformed. I'm not sure what happened there, but that's fine. It came that way and it adds character and makes it even more my plant. So I am absolutely okay with that. And that is my Hoya Latifolia. The next big leaf Hoya in my collection is my Hoya Sarawak. This is a popular plant among Hoya heads, guys, and you can see why just by looking at it. It is gorgeous. It has beautiful coloring and a light, delicate splash, and the growth pattern of the Sarawak is actually one of my favorites. I love a plant that grows leaves really close together and gives off more of that bushy vibe. One of my favorite things about this plant is its growth pattern and the beautiful leaves. They come in so dark and purpley red, and then they grow into these beautiful green splashy beauties with a nice dark margin. Cannot say enough good things about Hoya Sarawak, guys. My Hoya Sarawak lives in my Millsbow downstairs, and it gets the same condition as my other Millsbows. Nice humidity, bright light, and warmth. You can have this plant outside of a humid condition. It will just grow a little slower for you. No big deal. My next big leaf Hoya in my collection would be my Hoya Clandestina. This plant is also one of my favorites, guys. I got this from a private seller on Instagram. I will link her down below. She sells in her stories from time to time, and I believe she recently opened up an Etsy shop, and I highly, highly recommend her because she sells the best quality plants. I've never gotten a plant from this seller that I have not been absolutely in love with. And you can see why. Look how beautiful this plant is. It puts out these beautiful leaves that get nice and dark purple when they're sun stressed, and it is growing prolifically for me. This one is not in humidity and it is still growing really well. My average home humidity is around 10 to 15% on a good day. I live in a very dry climate and it still pushes out leaves regularly for me. It is in soil in terracotta and it's doing just fine with that. And that is my Hoya Clandestina. The next Hoya that I have that has big leaves is my Hoya Joy. She is great, guys. I love this plant. I do share this plant with my birthday. I got it on January 23rd of this year as a two-leaf cutting, and it has grown all of this in that amount of time. I did used to have it in my Millsbow cabinet, but it did outgrow it, so I have recently moved it out to my desk, and I am anticipating that it will take a little while for the growth to pick up as it acclimates to its new conditions. It is also starting to get a little top heavy, so I'm either going to have to find a heavier pot for it, or I'm going to need to trim it down. So let's see what happens. She's doing really well though. She's now on my plant desk and she is living her best life out here, getting in some sun from the southern and eastern exposure, and just continuing to help my desk look like a very jungly place, which I absolutely love. So that is my Hoya Joy. She's growing in pure cocoa husks and doing really well. Okay guys, let's see here. The next plant on my list would be my Hoya Skinneriana. And she has put out two smaller leaves for me recently because she's been acclimating to the pond, but you can see the gigantic leaf that she had to begin with. She also has a tendril starting to come out with some more leaves, and I'm hoping that those ones will also be on the large side. So I'm very excited for this plant to do something more for me. I am considering moving it into my Millsbow cabinet just to see if I can get a little bit more growth out of it, but we'll see what happens. You never know, I might stick it in there and see what we can get going with it. She lives in pond. She gets fertilized twice a month, every 2 weeks, and she gets exposure from an eastern and southern window here on a shelf on my wall. She's doing really well. She's been very stable for me and hasn't given me any issues, and this leaf is absolutely gorgeous. The big leaf is just so succulent and chunky. I absolutely really enjoy this plant. So guys, that is 5 big leaf Hoyas in my collection. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. It was a bit short and sweet, but I figured I would show you some really cool plants, possibly add to your wish list, and then just get you right back out to your day to enjoy. So if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to leave them below. Do you have any of these plants? What are some big leaf Hoyas you suggest I should try getting? I would love to hear that as well. You can find me and more pictures of these plants over on Instagram, and I am on TikTok. My link tree is listed down below, and I would love to see you there as well. If you're interested in any of the products that you saw, as far as the pots or the trellises or anything like that, please go ahead and check out my Amazon storefront. I have it all linked and organized there for you, so you don't have to try and find them places. It's all in one cohesive place. If you have any problems with that, definitely just hit me up a comment and I'll help you out. Otherwise, guys, thank you so much for joining me on this little trip through a few of my big leaf Hoyas. I definitely have more than just this, so if you would like a round 2 of big leaf Hoyas in my collection, absolutely just let me know and I will plan it for you. Thank you so much, and I hope you get to spend lots of quality time today with your plant babies. Thanks, guys. Bye.